guys, and welcome to What's Going On at Atlantic Cape. I'm Jim Bell, and here's the Atlantic Cape News Minute. SGA elections are on Wednesday, March 26. Make sure you stop in the J building and vote for next year's SGA. Friday, March 28th is the last day to withdraw from classes. If you need help, contact the registration department at registration@atlanticcape.edu or on campus. In case you weren't there for the event, here's a clip from the Atlantic Cape Gala. Atlantic Cape Community College will provide information for those looking to earn their degree, begin a new career, or enhance job skills at an open house from noon to 3 on Sunday, April 6. This event will begin in the Walter Edge Theater at the Mays Landing campus. On Thursday, April 10th, Atlantic Cape will be holding a career fair for the Mays Landing campus, the cafeteria, and the culinary wing from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Contact Autumn Bennett for more information. Now over to the Orange Hollis Report.
What's going on, Atlantic Cape, and welcome to the Autumn Tools Report. I hope you guys had a wonderful spring break and are ready to bring you guys the latest tech news of the week. This week, we're talking iPhone 6 along with Android Wear, and Amazon could make a phone of their own. Apple could be weeks away from starting production on the iPhone 6, according to Commercial Times report. Apple manufacturing partner Pegatron is apparently opening up a new factory space and recruiting workers to build the iPhone 6, according to the report. The production will begin in the second quarter, the newspaper said, citing unnamed sources. Pegatron wouldn't be the only manufacturer of Apple's flagship phone. The Commercial Times said Hanhai Precision Industry, also known as Foxconn, would be the primary manufacturer of the phone. Google has announced the Android Wear, which will shrink Android onto a variety of new wearable devices. The Android Wear-powered devices unveiled so far are the LG G Watch and the Moto 360, both coming this summer. They are sharp-looking watches that show how Google Now and other core services will work on the wrist. More details coming soon. New reports along suggest that the long-rumored Amazon smartphone is finally close at hand. Amazon to tech blog BGR KGI Securities analyst Ming Chang Koo predicted that Amazon will launch its own brand smartphone in 3 to 6 months using the same hardware strategies as used for its e-reader and tablet. Rumors point that the phone will have a 4.7-inch display, a quad-core Snapdragon A1 processor, and a battery capacity around 2,400 mAh batteries. In other words, it should be powerful enough to satisfy the needs for most users. Reports from last October tell us that Amazon is going to have the cameras in each corner of the front to track eye movements and gestures. That's it for this week's Autumn Tools Report. See you next week. So I pray.
What's up, Atlantic Cape? I'm Julian Anderson with your Sports Buzz, with my co-anchor of the day and TV Club's very own co-producer, Christina Holman. Today in the sports world, the Bucks softball team began their season with a doubleheader against Brookdale on Sunday. Samantha Hosey pitched an outstanding game during the opener, striking out 12 players at bat. Brookdale took home both games, but this is only the beginning of a good season to come. Also, the men's baseball team were supposed to play their first game last week against Gloucester, but were postponed due to inclement weather. But they play a doubleheader against Union County on the 29th. Come out and support our Bucks during their next game against Union County.
Thanks, Julian. And now for a little bit of extreme. Right before the spring break, a newly formed and unfortunately for many concerned Atlantic Cape students, still informal Atlantic Cape Community Ski Club took its first unaided trip to the Blue Mountain Ski Resort. Today in our studio, we have a special guest, the president of the club, Caitlin Glasser. Welcome, Caitlin.
Can you tell us a little bit about the ski club?
The ACCC Ski Club is a club that has no funding yet, which is really sad because our members are really excited about it. We took our first trip about 2 weeks ago and it was very successful. Although we only had seven kids, a lot of them got their first experience on a mountain and had a fun time.
How was the actual first club mountain trip?
The trip? The trip involved delicious food and wonderful experiences. Julian, one of the news network people here, after not snowboarding for about 5 years, got back up on his feet, did some cool moves, and we got to get him back on the mountain. It's a good opportunity for people to get back in touch with nature and friends.
And can we find your videos on YouTube anywhere?
Yes, if you go to YouTube, just look up Caitlin Glasser, my name. You'll see my face pop up. Click on that, go to ACCC Ski Club music video. It's hard to miss. And you'll see what our trips are all about and our club.
Well, thank you, Caitlin, for joining us today.
Thanks, Julian.
That's all for your Sports Buzz. I'm Julian Anderson.
And Christina Homan. See you next week.